It's easy to send your mains to your auxes. There are actually two different ways to accomplish this, depending on your application. Option one is to copy the main mix, in which we're going to duplicate the settings of your main levels, and then you can adjust individually to preference regardless of any changes made in the main mix. But for some applications, you need the aux mix levels to follow along with any changes made to the main mix. In this case, you'll want option two, follow the main mix. You can still make some adjustments to each channel, but the general level will follow the mains. Let's go ahead and take a look at both of these, starting with copy the main mix. Sometimes, the main mix can be a great starting point for a monitor mix. This is especially true for performers who are using in-ear monitors because they're only hearing what's coming into their earbuds, so they're probably going to want to get the entire mix sent to their ears. Or, if a performer isn't quite sure what they want to hear, you can simply copy the main mix and tailor it from there. To copy the main mix, select the main mix and push the Copy User button. On a TouchMix 30, this is U7. On a TouchMix 8 or 16, this will be U2. Now, navigate to the aux where you want the main mix to be applied and push the Paste User button, which is U8 on a TouchMix 30 and U3 on a TouchMix 8 or 16. If you're using a TouchMix 30 Pro, you also have aux-to-aux routing available on auxes 9 through 14. If you've pasted your main mix to one of these, any aux routing will be pasted along with the channel fader positions. You'll probably want to undo this. On the aux you've just pasted to, select the aux out 1 through 8 fader bank and drag all the faders all the way down. You can also press the zero button with the faders selected. Now do the same for the aux out 9 through 14 fader bank and the subgroups fader bank as well. Now, let's take a look at the second option, follow the main mix. Sometimes, you might need to create an aux mix that tracks the main mix. This could come up when doing front fill speakers or delays, or if you're sending a mix to a recording or broadcast device. Some engineers will do this for monitor mixes, but we don't recommend it because there's a lot of danger of feedback. We're going to start by setting the aux pickoff point to post fader. Select the aux mix that you want to route to the main mix. Touch the aux name above the output fader to access the aux output section and select the Setup tab. In the aux pickoff section, select Post Fader. The signals from each channel will now be picked off after the fader. Now bring all the aux mix faders to unity. Now, all of the channels are being delivered to the aux at the level of the main mix faders. Any change made to the main mix is going to be mirrored in the aux as well. Plus, you do still have the ability to boost or cut any of the inputs with the aux faders if necessary. For instance, if you add 3 dB to the guitar channel, then it will still follow the main mix as that channel is raised or lowered. It will simply always be 3 dB above the main mix settings. This lets you make a custom mix that still follows the main mix, but gives a larger or stronger presence to certain channels. Why would you want to do that? Let's say you're simultaneously doing a live mix as well as a webcast mix during a performance. The guitar amp is loud in the room and doesn't need much reinforcement there, but webcast listeners probably won't hear enough of the guitar, so you can boost the guitar channel in the aux mix only. Problem solved. Now, if you're using a TouchMix 30 Pro, there's a third option that's actually even easier. Within each aux mix is a dedicated fader for the main output. Bring this fader up in the aux and you're done. The difference here is that this main mix is already summed from your channels. So, while you could use one of the previous methods in addition to this main mix to boost a particular channel in your aux, there's no way to lower a particular channel since it's already baked into the main mix. Super simple, right? Thanks for watching this video. We'll see you next time.